Good afternoon, and today we shall solve the exercises for the exam of next week. I have put here 1, 2, 3, 4 exercises. Linear algebra, very simple. The differential equation, similar to yesterday evening, but of the second order instead of third order, and with only one exponential in the right hand side and not x exponential. Yesterday, the product x exponential made the computations very long. Today we have second order and then only two initial conditions. It will be shorter than yesterday. And then I have put exercise 3 and 4 because we recall the constraint optimization and also as well as the free optimization. Okay? Well, let's begin. Now I take away the share, otherwise the registration of what I write is not optimal. If you want, let's do so. Do a photo of the first exercise. Otherwise, I should put the share for every question. Either you copy or you do a photo of this exercise 1 in such a way that we can do the exercise 1 without sharing anymore. Then I insert again the share for the exercise 2 and so on. Okay? In this way I close the sharing. Someone of you has asked me about the registration of yesterday. I have not had time. Today in the evening I shall insert on my website web page both registrations of yesterday and of today. Don't worry. Well, I close the presentation. The sharing of the file. Well, now the first exercise reads so: given the canonical basis B of R3, E1, E2, E3, and of the vector space R2, R3, and the linear application. The linear application is written so. I copy the linear application. It's given so. L of E1 equal 3E1 minus 6E2 plus 9. Sorry, I have forgot here. Plus 9 E3. L of E2 equal negative 3E1 minus 3E2. L of E3 equal 6E2 minus 6E3. Pay attention, 6E2 minus 6E3. Without E1, here there is not E3. This is the linear application. And then, first question. Write the matrix A associated to the linear application L. L is from R2 3 into R2 3 into itself. This is an endomorphism. Well, the matrix A is...
Excuse me, I'm sorry. We cannot see clear.
Please.
Yeah, we cannot see clear.
Ah, you don't see clear?
Yes.
At the same time, you are moving rapidly. Please.
Depend on the light. On the light. Can you see clearer now?
Yes, yes. Thank you.
It depends on my light. I have not a professional system, but so it should be. You could see clearer. Otherwise, tell me. Don't ashamed.
No, it's clear. Please do it slowly as possible.
Yes. Yeah. Can you see clearer?
Yes.
Yes. Ah, I give you the time to copy if you could not see clear before. Yes. This is the definition of the linear application. Now, write the matrix associated to this linear application. You will remember, like yesterday evening, we put, you write in column the coefficients 3, negative 6, 9. Second column, you want 2 e 3, you want 2 e 3, negative 3, negative 3, 0. Okay, third column is 0, E1, E2, E3 is 0, 6, negative 6. This is the matrix, first question. Second question, find the subspaces, kernel and image, by writing their basis. Without a basis, the subspace does not make sense. A subspace is an abstract concept. Through its basis, it becomes concrete. Well, L of a generic vector V, V equal X, Y, Z. Row or column is the same for the quadratic forms. I have used the convention according to which a row is transpose V. V is the column X, Y, Z. But if both V and VT appear in a formula, then we must pay attention. If we have only V, for example, to give V equal a row or a column is the same. Important is the correct notation in the matrix, in the matrix product. Well, L of V is L becomes its concrete matrix representation. That is 3, negative 3, 0, negative 6, negative 3, 6, 9, 0, negative 6. Apply to V, that is X, Y, Z. In this case, we must write V in column on the right of the matrix. This is L of V. L of V is the V is in the first space. L of V is the result that we can call W. Okay. What is the result? The result will be 3x minus 3y plus 0. Second row, negative 6x minus 3y plus 6z. Third row, 9x plus 0y minus 6z. This is the result. Okay, we choose any triple, any vector V with three numeric components. We write the components here or here, and we have first, second, third component of the result. Okay, the kernel, I recall you, K care, denoted by care of L, is the set of those vector V belonging to a tree, such that L of V equal the null vector 0, 0, 0, the null vector of the second R tree. Okay, but L of V is this result. And then we must impose 3x minus 3y equals 0, negative 6x minus 3y plus 6z equals 0, 9x minus 6z equals 0. This is the linear system related to the kernel is a homogeneous system. At least we have the trivial solution. At a subspace, the kernel has at least the null vector, as we know. But is there only the null vector in the kernel or other infinitely many vectors? It depends on the rank. The rank of the matrix of the coefficients is coincident with the matrix A representing the linear application itself. And then, what is the rank of this matrix? The rank depends on the determinants. Okay, depends on the determinants means if the unique minor of order 3 has determinant not equal to 0, then the rank is 3. If the unique minor of order 3 has a vanishing determinant, the rank is less than 3. Less than 3 is 2. At least is 2. It is not possible that also all 9 minors of order 2 vanish. Because, for example, this minor of order 2 is not equal to 0. Negative 9 minus 18, and so on. Okay, the minus of order 2 can be easily seen at I without calculation. The minor of order 3 must be calculated. Determinant of 3, negative 3, 0, negative 6, negative 3, 6, 9, 0, negative 6, equal by using the first row, 3 times its complemental minor, which is the complemental minor of these 3 is this minor without the column and the row of the element. Here we have 18 minus 0, 18. Plus 3, the second element changes the sign, plus 3 times its complemental minor. I neglect the row, the column of negative 3 and the row. And then we have negative 6 times negative 6 is 36. 36 minus 9 times 6 is 54. 36 minus 54 is negative 18, equal 0. Okay. 54 minus 54 is 0. And then the rank of this matrix is 2. For example, we use this minor. Do you see how simple it is? I use this minor. So we have the system already decoupled. That is negative 3y. This minor is related to this part of the system. Okay, the theory of the linear system. Now we extract negative 3y equal negative 6z equal negative 3y equal negative 3x. Negative 6z equal negative 9x. Okay. Well, now x does not belong to the minor of the rank. Rank of A, I can write rank of A equal to, and then we have infinite to one solutions. That is, one is the dimension of the kernel of the subspace. Do you remember? Then x equal y equal z equal x is outside the minor and then takes an arbitrary value. An arbitrary value x equal 2t, not t, because with 2t we avoid, we eliminate the denominators in the fraction. X equal to t. I can write t to t. Every t, t with every coefficient is in principle is possible. Now we have negative negative become plus positive. Y equal negative 3 over negative 3, 3 over 3 is 1. Y equal t, y equal x. Otherwise, I can put negative 3y equal x takes the value 2t, and then here we have negative 3 times 2t is negative 6t. Negative 6z equal negative 8, 9 times 2, negative 18t. And then y equal 6 over 3 is 2, 2t. Z equal 18 over 6 is positive, perché because negative negative become positive. 18 over 6 is 3t. Okay? If we would have put x equal t, we would have obtained x equal t, y equal t, z equal 3t alpha, if we divide by 2. But if we can, we eliminate the denominator for the sake of simplicity. And then if we pass from the parametric form to the vector form, we can write x, y, z equal 2, 3, t. This is the basis of the kernel.
Però possiamo farle una domanda?
Please?
Se si prende un altro minor, da quello che ha selezionato lei, è possibile che i valori di x, y e z diversi?
No, it is not possible. If we take another minor, the only possibility is that this vector 2, 3 could become this vector times another coefficient. Let's do just a moment. I write and then I take another minor. Equal V belonging to R3 such that V equal 2, 3 times T. Okay. Another minor could be, let's take for example this minor, this complete minor. So in this case, the minor that I have used that does not require Cramer's rule. Now, if we take the first two rows, first two columns, rows and columns, we have 3x minus 3y equal negative 6x minus 3y equal. In the first equation we have 0. In the second equation, negative 6x minus 3y equal negative 6z. In the first equation is 0. In the second equation is negative 6z. Now, I take, for example, in this case, if we consider this minor corresponding to the first two rows and columns, in this case, Z is outside the minor. And Z takes an arbitrary value, any arbitrary value. Now, the arbitrary value, is, for example, X equal, Y equal, Z equal. Let's put 3T, or if you want, only T. Otherwise, someone of you could ask, from where does 3T rains? Da dove piove? And then I write T. Well, let's compute X and Y. The system becomes 3X minus 3Y equals 0. Negative 6X minus 3Y equals negative 6T. Okay? Without using Cramer's rule, I rewrite 3x minus 3 minus 3y equals 0. Or, no, so, in the second equation, I change the sign. 6x plus 3y equals positive 60. Now we sum side by side. 6x times plus 3x is 9x. 3y minus 3y, or negative 3y plus 3y is 0, equal 60. 0 plus 60 is 60. Now, x equal 6 over 9. 6 over 9 is 2/3 t. And now, from the first equation, x equal y, we get from the first equation. And then, if x is 2/3 t, y is 2/3 t. And then we have x, y, z equal 2/3, 1 times t. But this vector is not really coincident with this vector, but it does not matter, because when we have a vector representing, spanning a subspace of dimension 1, important is the line, not the length. Let's suppose that a subspace is this line passing through the origin, obviously. If we consider on this line, this vector or this vector is the same, okay? The line is the absolute object, geometric object. How we represent the line is not relevant. All these vectors belong to the same line, because the second vector, the first vector, is the second multiplied by 3. Here we have, for example, 2/3, 2/3, 1. And this vector is 2/3, but on the same line. Because the longer vector is the shorter vector times 3. When two vectors are connected by the multiplication by the coefficients, the two vectors are linearly dependent. That is, they belong on the same to the same line. Okay. And then the minor is not relevant, but with this minor, the computation is immediate.
Perfetto, grazie mille.
Thank you. No, not at all. Now, and then we have dimension of the kernel of L equal one, the equal to the exponent of the infinite in Ruscha-Capelli's theorem. Since we have that this is the dimension of the first space, the sum of the two dimensions of the kernel and of the image is three, must be three, according to that famous theorem. And then the dimension of the image of L is one plus this image, this dimension must be three. And then this dimension is two. One plus two equal three. The kernel is contained in the first R3, the image in the second R3, but it is the same unique R3 of the dimension of the image is two. What is, and then the basis of the kernel is only this one vector that I take in this form and not in this form. 2, 2, 3. This is the only basis vector of the kernel. The image has dimension 2. And then for the dimension, we have two basis vectors. The dimension of the image of L equal. The dimension is two, and then two vectors. Which two vectors? Two vectors contained in the minor of the rank two of the matrix associated to the linear application. Either second and third column, or first and second column, but anyway, only two columns, because all columns are linearly dependent because the determinant is zero. All three vectors taken as columns are linearly dependent. They are not a basis, obviously. Okay, and then I write, for example, -3, -3, 0. I consider this minor. -3, -3, 0. All 3, 3, 0. If I change the sign of a vector, the vector becomes from so, it becomes so. But anyway, the same line, it spans the same line. And then -3, -3, 0, this column, and then 0, 6, -6. This is the basis of the image. Or we divide by 3, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, minus 1. Okay, this is the basis of the image, dimension 1, dimension 2, dimension of the image of L equal to 1 the kernel plus 2 is 3, like the first space, the dimension of the first space. Okay, and now we have answered to the first and second equation. Let us consider, just a moment, I share again.
Fare una domanda.
Yes, please.
La base, la prima base, il primo vettore dovrebbe essere meno 3 e meno 3.
This vector. Where? Here?
No, è il primo vettore della base meno 3. Dovrebbe essere meno 3, meno 3, 0.
Ah, yes, 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 yes. No, I have said negative 3, negative 3, 0. But if I change the sign, for example, if these two vectors would be so, V1, V2, if we change the sign of V1, that is, we take, this is the same V2. But if we change V1 with its opposite vector, this is another basis, always a basis.
Okay.
The changement of the sign of a vector does not usually gives no difference. In general, usually, then it depends on there could be some specific case, but in general, if you have three basic vectors, if you change the sign, if these vectors are linearly independent and they form a basis, if I change a sign, the new three vectors remain independent. The change of a sign cannot transform linearly dependent independent vectors into dependent vectors, because the linearly dependence or independence is related, is connected with the directions, with the lines, and not with the verse of the vector, toward the left or toward the right. Ok,
excuse me, professor.
Yes.
But when we change the basis of the image, the second vector of the second base should not be 0, 2, minus 2. Don't we have to divide by 3?
Here?
Yes.
You mind here? Oh, you have said the new basis. I have not written the basis yet. I have said I take the basis is given by those columns involved contained into the minor. If I consider this minor here, I consider the second and third column, or the first and second column. Well, if I take these two columns, the second basis vector is 0, 6, minus 6. Now we divide by 6, 0, 1, negative 1. 0, 2, negative 2, it's good the same. This vector comes from the division by 3, 6 divided by 3, negative 6 divided by 3. But if I divide both by 6, the number is more simplified, so to say.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Okay. Well, now the third question is, let's consider another linear application. This second linear application is given through the transformation laws, it's written here, the transformation laws of the components, not of the vectors. Here I have said It is wrong because this is E3. Here we have the same space. We don't need to write E and F, only E. E3, here I have forgot to write E3. This is E3, like here in my sheet, in my paper. Well, let's consider this second tilde L, not L, L and tilde L. Tilde L is given so, L tilde of X, Y, Z. A linear application is always given, requires that we specify how it transforms the vector. L of a vector X, Y, Z. X, Y, Z is V, L of V, equal, we read here, X minus Y, comma, X plus Z, comma, X minus Y plus Z. Okay? Now, third question. Write the matrix B. Pay attention, this is the matrix A, the matrix of the linear application L. Now we have a second linear application, tilde L. What is the matrix associated to tilde L? The answer is, we must imagine a matrix times X, Y, Z. The matrix is the representation of the linear application, of the abstract linear application. The matrix acting on X, Y, Z must give the result X minus Y, X plus Z, X minus Y plus Z. What is the matrix giving this result? It is very simple. 1, 1, 0. Sorry, 1, negative 1. Do you see? Row times column. 1 times X. X minus Y plus 0. X minus Y. The second component is given by the second row. 1X plus 0Y plus 1Z. Okay? The third component of the result is given by the third row, 1, negative 1, 1. This is the matrix B. The matrix B associated to tilde B is associated to tilde L. A is associated to L. Okay. Now, write the matrix B associated to the linear application tilde L. This linear application has this matrix. Now, this is B. Write the matrix B associated to the linear application L with respect to the given basis. And determine the matrix denoted by M, the matrix M, equal the matrix associated to the product of linear applications in the order, the matrix product is not commutative, in the order there is L tilde L. What is the matrix M associated to this product of linear applications? Equal, M will be equal to the product of the corresponding matrices. L is represented by capital A. Tilde L tilde L is represented by B. Ok? M will be given by this simple prod matrix product. Just a moment, I break the presentation. Then I share share again if it is necessary. Now we compute AB, M equal AB. But first I break the registration.